Hi, and welcome to CVS Health Live, our ongoing series that delivers timely perspectives and relevant insights into healthcare issues that are happening right now. I'm Jessica DaMassa. Well, the big news coming out of CVS Health is the launch of their new Health Zones initiatives. And so today we are getting the inside story on Health Zones and how they are working to address different social determinants of health issues in order to improve overall health outcomes and well-being in communities that are at risk. So we have a lot to unpack here, including where the health zones are going to be launched, some of the social determinants of health that they're going to tackle, and some exciting collaborations with organizations like Uber Health and UMOM New Day Centers that are going to be put into place to help bring others into this very important work. So with that, let's introduce our panel of experts on all things health zones. From UMOM New Day Centers, we have their CEO, Jackson Fonder. From CVS Health, we have their Vice President and Chief Health Equity Officer, Dr. Joneigh Khaldun. And also from CVS Health, Senior Vice President of Corporate Social Responsibility and Philanthropy, Eileen Boone. So this is an exciting launch, and I am so excited to jump into all of this with you so that we can hear all of the details. Eileen, I want to kick off and start with you, if we can. So, I mean, for those who have not seen the Health Zones announcement, get us up to speed. Tell us about this exciting initiative and where it will focus.
So we are so proud to talk about this endeavor. This is a community investment strategy that really is working towards reducing healthcare disparities and advancing health equity. And we do that through an integrated approach around social determinants of health. We're looking at housing, we're looking at education, access to healthcare, labor, and training and transportation. So this has been a real wonderful opportunity to really bring an integrated approach to underserved communities. And we are working very hard with trusted partners in the market like Jackson here. This has been a real true testament to the ability of coalitions to identify the highest level of need in populations and deliver products and services that help them get to their best potential.
All right, Joneigh, I want you to chime in here for us if you can. So, I mean, in your role as CVS Health's first Chief Health Equity Officer, you're leading the strategy for bringing health equity into the organization, bringing it to CVS Health's patients, providers, into the communities or customers. Talk to me about some of the other initiatives that you're working on. I know Health Zones is part of this, but how else are you bringing this strategy to life? And, you know, why is the time right now for CVS Health to be focusing on health equity as an issue?
Absolutely. So thank you, Jessica. And thank you, Eileen. I'm really excited to talk about our launch today. So I think, you know, when we think about and talk about health equity, we have to really think about those root causes of the inequities and disparities, and then be very intentional about how we address them. So we all know the reason why these disparities exist and why there's differences in outcomes among races has nothing to do with anyone's skin color, right? It has to do with how people experience the world and, quite frankly, structural barriers, social determinants of health, and historically racism as well. And so that means to address health equity, we really have to look at those historical kind of root causes. I think of it as three buckets. So culture, measurement, and then action or program. So from a culture standpoint, how are we looking at our internal policies? How are we thinking about training our workforce so that they can be empowered to address health inequities every day when they come to work? Measurement, how are we thinking about data? How are we tracking not just race and ethnicity, but also language, preferred language? How are we thinking about disability status? How are we thinking about sexual orientation and gender identity? And then programs, how are we using that data to be able to activate our programs to be able to address those disparities? So that's really how I think about health equity when we talk about CVS Health and really leveraging all of our amazing assets across the enterprise. You know, I think the time is now to move this forward with sustained action. The disparities that we've seen with COVID-19 weren't a surprise, but they've certainly alarmed all of us. And there are specific actions we can take to be able to address it. So I think we do have a real opportunity to improve the health outcomes of underserved communities.
All right, Eileen, so I know that Health Zones is launching in some key markets to start out. So Atlanta, Fresno, Columbus, Hartford, and Phoenix. But tell us what's next and what's on tap. Why were these markets chosen in the first place? And do you have plans for expansion this year?
So Health Zones were identified because of the greatest need. and the greatest opportunity for us to bring our size and scale. So we started with our affordable housing units and then looked for partners in the market that really could wrap around services to identify target populations. And so it really is this philosophy of meeting this population where they are. So we've chosen those markets, those five markets. We're really thrilled with them. We're looking to see how this unfolds over the next 5 years. We'll look at more markets as well. But I think you'll see over time that we'll evolve our strategy. And partners like Jackson just talked about how important housing is. Those types of things might be changing over time as the population changes, as the increase of the population in the market. So we're really looking forward to be flexible and adaptable and really meet the highest needs of this population.
All right, Jackson, I'm going to bring you into the conversation here. So I know that UMOM New Day Centers is collaborating with CVS Health on the Health Zone initiatives. You're based out in Phoenix, but why don't you just get us an introduction to the organization? Tell us what you do, what role you play in the community, and then what part you're going to be playing in Health Zones.
Thanks, Jessica. Yeah, UMOM operates the Family Housing Hub. So the first thing you need to know about UMOM is we're sort of a three-piece organization. Emergency shelter, workforce development, and finally affordable housing. But it all starts with that family housing hub, and that's where every family who's experiencing homelessness in the greater Phoenix area, they have to come to us for help, and we direct them from there. Sometimes it's on our campus, and sometimes it's throughout the community. So we're the state's largest emergency shelter for families. So we interact with almost every single family that's faced with homelessness in this area. So our vision in this area is to see people who live in the health zones get focused on staying healthy and bringing up their families with access to healthcare services, whether that's something simple like monthly screenings that can help them identify potentially serious health concerns or getting actual medical attention itself. We currently really focus on existing families and always talk about the future so that we can break this cycle of homelessness, because the valley is the valley of the sun, as we refer to it down here, because we're one of the fastest growing metropolitan areas in the country, convening a variety of partners and organizations who work with underserved communities is absolutely critical to reaching as many people as we can so that we can have meaningful impact.
All right, Eileen, I wish I had time here to dive into like each and every component of the health zone strategy, but I don't. So I've got to pick and choose. So I want to hear a little bit about some of the other, you know, the other collaborations that CVS Health has put together, you know, in order to engage other organizations into this and address different aspects of social determinants of health. So in particular, I'd like to ask about the collaboration with Uber Health and tackling this issue of transportation as a social determinant of health. So can you elaborate on this collaboration, how it's going to work, where it's going to be rolled out, when it's going to be available? Tell us about all that.
So thank you for the question, because you really nailed it. Transportation is a barrier to healthcare. And we learned that not only anecdotally through our partners, but in the local market, we see as an opportunity to really connect and keep those patients engaged in their healthcare. So it has been a wonderful collaboration with Uber Health. They've been very flexible. The program's going to start February 1st, and we're working with nonprofits that will facilitate and identify those participants in the program. So for example, we've identified doctor's appointments and workforce or educational programs, making sure that those people who don't have a ride don't miss those opportunities to either take care of themselves or get the education that they need. So it's a opportunity to, again, bring this integrated approach in the zone to really connect people with where they need to be, and how to do that in a partnership model has been a really exciting opportunity for us.
Joneigh, add to this for us, please. I mean, I'm curious, you know, it's like, as we talk about in the context of social determinants of health, what other areas are available to CVS Health where you guys can really make a difference in terms of, you know, reducing healthcare inequity or reducing health disparities?
You know, I think it's important when we talk about social determinants of health, and as we work to partner with communities, as Eileen mentioned, is that we really work to understand the needs of our communities. We know that access to transportation, again, as Eileen mentioned, is important. And when people don't have that access, it can absolutely contribute to poor health outcomes. And so that's why this partnership with Uber is really just so exciting and important. But, you know, we also know that every community does not manifest those transportation or other social determinant of health problems the same. I've had the opportunity to work in Detroit, in New York City, in Philadelphia. And while those are urban settings, they're all very different. We know urban is different than rural. So it's really important that we understand data, that we really work closely with communities to understand their needs. And then we leverage all of our amazing assets at CVS Health to be able to work with the communities to address those challenges. And that's whether it's housing, access to high quality, affordable food, jobs, or transportation.
Jackson, I do want to ask you about housing here. I want to hear a little bit more about the role that UMOM plays in terms of helping people get back on their feet so that they can actually be in a safe place, in a position where they can actually focus on their health and their well-being. Tell me a little bit more about that in terms of how you help people, you know, find what they need and help them prioritize their health based on taking care of their housing needs.
Yeah, it's such a critical role. UMOM is much more than just a bed for the duration that a family stays with us, which is anywhere from 60 to 120 days. We offer a full variety of services to help people get back on their feet. I think about what it's like for these families to have a personal case manager help them with a customized plan first to get a job. And it's much more than that. It's about writing a resume and applying and searching and preparing for Zoom interviews and in-person interviews. One of my favorite pieces about that is employment preparation. A lot of our clients have been away from the workforce for a long time. So what's that like? What happens if I get into a little bit of an argument at work? How do I dress? What about time management? We help teach all of that. One of our key services also, because at any given time we have 350 kiddos on this campus, we have an on-site medical clinic that really helps the families with their medical needs. I say all of this because the lack of a house, of affordable housing is a tremendous drag on families experiencing homelessness. A mental drag, a physical drag. Living on the streets and in cars is not just stressful, it can literally make people sick trying to survive the elements of Phoenix, Arizona. You think about the summers here and the idea around dehydration and sunburn and heat stroke and such. A lot of people won't search or seek medical treatment if they don't have a regular health provider. Well, they won't go anywhere near a health care provider unless we can address the housing first. People who get housing first have such an advantage because this weight is lifted off their shoulders. And when that weight is lifted off, they can focus on these other things. A job, my kids, staying healthy, becoming financially savvy so I can afford to live in a permanent place. All of these things come under one category: safe housing, affordable housing.
And that's so interesting to me. And I think the work that you're doing at UMOM really underscores the importance of zooming in on the local level. Eileen, I want to ask you about this as well. You know, I mean, you started off by saying, I mean, this is a focus on zip codes kind of initiative. And I would like to get a little bit more from you in terms of, you know, hearing how important these community focused initiatives are and how they can really drive change and very quickly in at-risk communities. So, I mean, for you here, you know, at the top of the launch of Health Zones, what does success look like? And how are you guys measuring, you know, impact and outcomes to make sure that you're hitting the right parts of this?
Well, that's a great opportunity for us to think about how we iterate. So tracking data, understanding outcomes, using our partners' survey tools, tracking the number of meals that we're putting in the community, and talking to the patients themselves to really understand, are we affecting change and are we doing that in a meaningful way? So it is very much a part of the Health Zone model. Measurement, as Joneigh very eloquently points out, is key to all of this. Data is really an element that is going to help us make better decisions as we go forward. So we're relying on our partners like Jackson to help us and truly track our folks in those markets and really get to the most important thing, which is keeping people healthy, making sure they have access to the things that they need the most.
I love that. And Jackson, I want to get your input here on something that Eileen just said, you know, about the boots on the ground, because I think, you know, one of the things that I find so interesting here is how CVS Health has decided to partner with other organizations like yours, or to collaborate with organizations, you know, otherwise, you know, but on the boots on the ground piece of this, I mean, for those who might be listening and you know, want to get involved some way, tell us about the importance of organizations like yours that are there in the community day to day on the ground helping out. You know, I mean, why is it important to work with organizations like yours?
First of all, we could never do this by ourselves. And you add the innovative approach that CVS brings to the table, along with UMOM and all the other partners that are involved here, this sort of spider web network, You can't stop a force like that. Groups that are on the ground and operating within the community, they build trust with the with neighborhoods there. We've been there for 60 years in the most needed neighborhoods, and they trust us and we trust them, and we work very well together. So we depend on those relationships to get stuff done, to move the needle. And working together, as always, as anybody knows, is a lot more powerful than trying to do it by yourself. We can solve more problems. We can have a greater impact. After all, no child should have to live on the streets. And we actually believe that we can solve family homelessness.
Joneigh, as CVS Health works to solve for health equity, you know, other than community investment, I mean, what else is out there? What else are you focusing on? What other solutions do you feel need to be activated in order to make a difference and really move the needle in the health equity conversation?
You know, I'm going to build on this theme. You know, it's really about the community. It's about looking at data and then listening to the community and partnering based on what the community identifies and filling in those gaps with their assets. So whether it's someone who's with Aetna or has Caremark, someone who's visiting our pharmacy, our retail store, our health hub, we really need to think about the customer experience. We need to think about how we are sharing access to services in a way that's culturally responsive. And we have to think about how we're engaging those communities. What was just spoken about as far as engagement and trust, that's just so critical to health equity. And of course, as Eileen said, holding ourselves accountable for those measurable outcomes. But let me also say, you know, CVS Health has been a leader for decades, really, in the health equity space. In 2003, through Aetna, we were the first health plan to actually start using data, so race and ethnicity data, to understand health disparities and to design programs to be able to address them. We've been a leader throughout the COVID-19 response, over 50 million vaccines, over 41 million tests through the end of last year, and a large amount of those being in underserved communities. So we have absolutely been a leader. We will continue to lead in the health equity space. And that's really what it's about, bringing our heart to every moment of your health. So I'm really excited to lead alongside so many great leaders at CVS Health and in our communities in this space.
All right, Joneigh, Jackson, Eileen, thank you so much for joining us here and for giving us all of this insight into health zones right as you guys are launching this exciting new initiative. We love the launch of new things here on CVS Health Live, and we also love when people come back and tell us how they're going. So we hope that we get to talk with all of you again here soon to get an update on how the program is rolling out and some of the impact that it's making. Until then, if you want to check out more information about health zones or any of the other exciting initiatives that CVS Health is working on, check out the CVS Health website. You can take a look at the URL that's appearing on your screen right now specifically to hear about health zones. Or you can join us again on a future episode of CVS Health Live, and hopefully we'll be diving deeper into this topic then. I'm Jessica DaMassa. Thank you so much for joining us. Take care.